Welcome back to the channel where we continue to talk digital marketing strategy. And today we are going to talk about email strategy and the best way to ensure success with your email strategy. We are going to talk about the successful components when you are putting together an email strategy. And again, a strategy is your overarching plan of action. It is what you are trying to accomplish. Tactics are individual emails into individual things. So the strategy we're going to talk about today is an engaging subject line, a great offer, provide value, strategy to engage with your email list, and then personalized content. Let's take a look at each of these individually. Now, the subject line is one of the most important parts of an email. Probably the thing that you should spend the most time on, just as much time on as writing the copy. And a lot of times you want to start with writing the email subject before you write the copy. So lay out the subject, then that's where you start looking at some of the copy for the email. A lot of times people do this backwards. They'll write the email, then they'll try to pick a subject, and it's kind of hard to match it up. Shorter is better. 5 to 7 words for your email subject lines. Provide a hook, and by a hook, something that gets them interest. A stat sometimes can be in the subject, like 56% or 72% do this. Name in your subject. If you put the subject's first name in that email subject line, that may get you some more opens. Ask a question or list a problem. Kind of come out to them in the email subject like, you're having problems with this too. These are just ways to kind of pique that interest so that when they open the email, you kind of have the 5-second rule, but a lot of times if the subject doesn't match the message, you can lose them right away. Second part of the email strategy is an offer. Make sure that the offer is compelling. 1% off or 5% off a lot of times on emails. And if you send that email out every single week, there's nothing compelling about that offer. They've seen it before. They know they'll see it again. It kind of becomes like wallpaper. Make sure it does match the subject line. If you're putting an offer in the subject line, then make sure that's what the email is about. Is it memorable? Does the offer have something where they'll either save it or search for it or forward it on to somebody else? A lot of times with emails and specials and things like that, you can go for the ask. Ask them to forward it to a friend. Ask them to respond to the email. Talk about the benefits of why this email is important from a consumer standpoint. Don't list necessarily all the features that you're trying to sell. List the benefits. Can it save them time? Can it save them effort? Can it get them more questions? You want to provide something in that offer that says, this is why this is important. It must have value. Again, what is it worth to them? Not how much it's going to make for you. Does it hook them? Look at price, convenience, and then also look for solutions. In that email, 1 or 2 photographs, high-res images, or something that they can identify with. Solve a pain point. You're always trying to solve pain points with the customer, either in an email, reference an article, reference a blog, reference a video. Then always have the ask at the end. One call to action is usually the best form in an email so that you don't get too many calls to action, and have it be more of an action verb like buy now, order today, learn more, click here for details, something to get them to respond right away. Your click-through rate, again, is more important sometimes than your open rate. If you have a very high open rate but a low click-through rate, that means you're not getting them to your website. The offer is not compelling them to continue on with that email engagement. Then the next thing you want to do is engage. Get them to call to an action, click that button, watch a video, learn more, ask them a question in an email to respond back, and then actually go to that email box. Have a email box set up like Ask Joe or Ask Frank. And then if you, or ask a name rather than just an inbox or sales or marketing. If you can have an actual extra inbox created that's and then have the reply tos go to there and try to encourage people to respond to the emails and then actually go in. Now again, this is more for smaller lists and more for personalized services like plumbers and HVAC specialists, lawyers, financial planners, things like that. You can actually engage with them, get them to respond to the email, ask a question in that email. And the fifth thing you want to do is personalize. This is about segmentation, putting them in buckets. What have they bought in the past? Give them a certain email. What brands have they purchased? If they've already purchased your product, what is the upsell? Try to get them to renew. If there's a software as a service, try to get them keep track of their renewal date and send them a renewal maybe 60 days out. Set up some kind of regular cadence so that you can start to get them renewals earlier or know if they're going to have a chance to renew. So your email strategy, again, is part of a full marketing strategy. You want to test your subject lines. You want to have segmentation. You want to engage with them. Again, with personalized products, have you ever tried the 8-word email? This is just a simple, short email. If you're a real estate agent, you'd say, "Are you still looking for a home?" If you're a financial planner, you'd say something like, "Have I answered all of your questions?" Get them to re-engage the second they reply to that email, then put them in a segmented bucket, and then come back at them with the answer or the question that you initiated that engagement, and then give them more information or follow up with the information that they provide you. This is all part of a strong digital marketing strategy as you continue to build out your marketing and your marketing strategy for 2023.